Welcome back to the research world. Today, learning objectives are: what is a research gap and sources of the research gap, how to identify the research gap. If you are a researcher, the first challenge is to identify an interesting and worthy research topic. Let's start. Five most important sources for finding the research gap. Source number first: literature review. The old research literature gives an idea for the gaps in the research report. It can be found under the topics like scope, limitations, suggestions that mentions the gap left over by the earlier researcher. So, the literature review is the first important source for identifying and finding a perfect research gap. Source number two: a few commercial or social activity-based organizations focus a lot on the problem-solving areas. They also keep writing and mentioning the social issues in their newsletter, or they put it on their public domain. Such articles are excellent sources of the real social issues on which a research gap could be identified. So the source number second is about the activity-based organizations focusing on the problem-solving issues. That is, the organizations that are emphasizing and focusing on the real problem-solving issues. So that is the source number second for identifying a research gap. Source number three. Source number three is the most cited research articles or the research papers. They may give a clue on the inspiring and the motivating research gaps for you. Those help with the understanding of the current topics among the researchers and identify the gaps in their research work. So if you are looking for a very interesting research gap, for a very emphasizing research topic, you can Google or you can search for the most cited research articles or the research papers. They can help you in identifying a very perfect research gap for your topic. Source number four. Source number four for identifying the research gap is: in discussion with other research colleagues, the research guides or the advisors, you may get an inspirational research area that might be unexplored, thus the new research gap. So the source number four is the discussion with the experts, with the research colleagues, with advisors, who can help you in identifying a research gap for your topic. Source number five. The last but not the least. Source number five for identifying the research gap is: several research areas can be found on the digital platforms like social media, the research-related websites, or even the magazines and journals give an idea that could be picked up or modified as per the scope and limitations for the new research gap. So these are the most important and most widely used sources for identifying a research gap. Thank you for watching. Like and share.